Hello everyone, today we would be discussing the daily MCQs of July 27, 2018. And as you know, these MCQs are very important for the upcoming RBI Phase 1 examination and the SBI mains examination. Along with this, the IBPS mains examination. Some of the current affairs are even asked in the SSC CGL examination. Thus, these current affairs have a great value for these exams. You can also visit www.anujjindal.in. to attempt the daily current affairs quiz and read the material for the current affairs there. Now let's begin with the first question. Which of the following has been launched by the collaboration between Atal Innovation Mission and My Government? So the Niti Aayog's Atal Innovation Mission and My Government have jointly launched the hashtag Innovate platform. Hashtag Innovate India platform. It is a citizen-centric platform and actually a much-needed innovation platform that aims to serve as a common point for innovation happening across the nation, and it registers both the grassroots and the deep tech innovators at the national level. So, Niti Aayog's Atal Innovation Mission and My Government have launched the hashtag Innovate India platform. Another question is, which of the following has formed a monitoring committee for Yamuna Rejuvenation Project or Redevelopment Project? So, the National Green Tribunal or the NGT has come up with the forming of this monitoring committee for Yamuna Rejuvenation Project, and along with this, they have asked the Haryana government and the UP government to assist the committee for this project. Along with this, they have directed authorities to take strict action against encroachments on the Yamuna floodplains. Next question is, Dash has become the leading state for renewable energy in India according to the report released by Institute for Energy Economics and Financial Analysis. So first of all, let's know which report has been released by this institute. The name of the report is Karnataka's Electricity Sector Transformation. And if you wish to guess the answer for this question, then it's Karnataka. And the correct answer is also Karnataka. So Karnataka has become the leading state for renewable energy in India. Let's look at some of the stats of Karnataka. So the state or Karnataka has reached 12.3 gigawatt of total installed capacity as of March 2018, and they have added 5 gigawatts alone in the year 2017-18. Now currently it has 5 gigawatt of solar capacity. We are now looking at the distribution of this total installed capacity in terms of the different renewable energy. So currently it has 5 gigawatts of solar capacity and 4.7 gigawatts of wind capacity. The remainder, which is approximately 2.6 gigawatt, includes the small hydro or the biomass plus the heat and power congregation. So the remaining comes in the 2.6 gigawatt. The major leader or the major contributor is the solar capacity generator. Next question is, Project Gandev has been launched in which state? So Andhra Pradesh wants its state to compete at the national and international level. Therefore, they have launched this Project Gandev so that they can groom their talented sportsperson and train them to compete at these sports meet like Olympics or other national and international sports events. Next question is, which is currently the operational longest road tunnel in India? So this is quite a confusing question as it asks about the operational longest road tunnel. The current operational longest road tunnel in India is Chenani Nashri tunnel, which is 9.2 kilometers. Now, there is a proposal for the another longest road tunnel, or which is believed to be longest road tunnel, but it is still under construction and the name of the tunnel is Jozila Tunnel. which is proposed to be 14.2 kilometers and is expected to be the country's longest road tunnel. But the question is asking about the currently operational longest road tunnel. So currently operational road tunnel is Chenani Nashri Tunnel. Now, why this question has been asked, or why this Chenani Nashri Tunnel has been in the news? So Cube Highways has initiated talks with the ILNFS Transportation Network Limited to acquire their 9.2 kilometers or Chenani Nashri Tunnel. So Cube Highways has come up to IL and FS Transportation Network to acquire this project in Jammu and Kashmir. If we look at the other option, then Peer Panjal Tunnel is the India's longest railway tunnel. What is the name of all women hotel launched by Kerala Tourism Development Corporation, KTDC? So a flagship project of Kerala Tourism Development Corporation has been launched, named Hostess, and this would come up in 6 months at the KTDC complex. This is a first of a kind hotel, or it is claimed to be first of a kind hotel in India, which is run entirely by women and will serve women. Which of the following software would be provided to all universities free of cost to detect plagiarism? So these all are the softwares for plagiarism, and the University of Human Resource Development, or the HRD Minister Prakash Javedkar, has proposed to provide all the universities with the Turnitin software to detect plagiarism in research. Now, what is plagiarism? So plagiarism is a practice of taking someone else's work or ideas and passing them off as one's own. So if I'm stealing the work or idea of some other person and passing them to the other person, or selling them to the other person, claiming it to be mine, then it is known as plagiarism. What is the name of the social networking app launched by China's Toutiao? So China's Toutiao, which is one of the world's most valuable startup, has launched a social networking app called Hello. Don't get confused with the word hello. It is spelled as H-E-L-O, Hello. This is an important question, and the question says, the Reserve Bank of India is moving to shut down the CDR system. What does CDR stand for? So CDR stands for Corporate Debt Restructuring, and RBI is moving to shut down this CDR system. Along with this, it has directed the CDR cell, or the Corporate Debt Restructuring cell, to transfer all the pending cases to the respective lead banks to complete the resolution process. If we look at the latest available data, then CDR cell has approved restructuring of stress loans worth 4 trillion since its inception in 2001. So CDR system came in the year 2001, and till that year they have approved the restructuring of stress loans of rupees 4 trillion. Out of this, rupees 84,677 crore worth of loans have exited the CDR cell successfully, and around 1.84 trillion without success. The last question for today is, who among the following is the recipient of Raymond Magsaysay Award? All the options mentioned here, the three names, Bharat Vatwani, Bezwada Wilson and Sonam Wangchuk, have received Raymond Magsaysay Award. Bharat Vatwani and Sonam Wangchuk received this award in 2018 itself, and Bezwada Wilson received this award in 2016. Now, Bharat Vatwani has received this award for rescuing thousands of mentally ill, destitute people and reuniting them with their families. And what about Sonam Wangchuk? So Sonam Wangchuk received this for the contribution in the field of education, culture and progress of communities in the remote northern India. This is all for today. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal. Do mention your feedback in the comment section below. Along with this, join our YouTube community where you can attempt the daily current affairs quiz and get the latest announcements and updates. Join our Facebook and Telegram Success SBI and Success RBI Group. You can also join us on WhatsApp. There's an Android app named Infinity which you can download from the Google Play Store and attempt the daily current affairs and access all the courses on your mobile phone. Thank you for watching the video.